Let's turn to Hebrews chapter 11.
让我们翻开到希伯来书第11章。
Once again, we look at another character.
我们再次来看另一个人物。
Men who God said they exhibited the fruit of the Spirit.
就是神说他有结出这个圣灵果子这方面就是信实。
Praise for their faith.
他们的这个信心被神称赞。So
what can we learn from them?
所以我们可以从他们身上学什么?
Let's read from verses 24 to 27, please.
所以请我们读11章24到27节。24 to 27.
First in Mandarin, then in English.
我们先用华语，然后用英语来读。摩西因着信。 长大了就不肯称为法老你儿子子，他宁可和神的百姓同受苦害，也不愿暂时享受最终之乐。他看为基督受的凌辱，比埃及的财物更宝贵，因他向往所要得的赏赐。他因着信就离开埃及，不怕亡怒，因为他恒心忍耐。
In English, verse 24, by faith Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season, esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt. For he had respect unto the recompense of the reward. By faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. Now here God describes what was in Moses' heart when he was in Egypt.
这里神形容了在摩西心里面所想的，当他在埃及的时候。
What was his faith about?
他的信心是关于什么?
What aspect that made God praise him that he has displayed the fruit of the Spirit?
他这样子表现出圣灵果子的这方面信心是哪一方面使到神这样的来称赞他?
Of faith.
就是在信心这方面。
Now remember that God described various people.
记得神形容了几
In different situations,
在不同的情况,
going through different challenges,
他们是经过不同的挑战,
different temptations,
不同的试探,
and for us to learn from each one of them, when a man displays the fruit of the Spirit, faith, how does he behave?
那要让我们来学习，就是这每一个人，当他们表现出这圣灵果子这方面信心的时候，那他们是有怎样的行为？
Now, especially this aspect, fruit of the Spirit, faith, it is a personal something that's in us, personal. This last three aspects.
特别是这圣灵果子的最后这三方面，就其中这方面信心，信实或者是信心，它是在我们里面内心里面的。
Look at verse 23.
我们来看第23节。
God says, by faith, Moses, when he was, verse 23 first. By faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw he was a proper child and they were not afraid of the king's commandment.
我们现在看23节，说摩西生下来，他的父母见他是个俊美的孩子，就因着信把他藏了3个月，并不怕亡命。
Now, here is first the description of his birth.
这里是先讲到他的出生。
And then verse 24, you will notice it says by faith, when Moses was come to years. Now talks about he has grown up.
第24节说到摩西因着信长大了，这里是讲到摩西长大了过后。
He was spared from being killed when he was a child.
当他 小的时候，做小孩的时候，他逃脱了，他没有被杀害。
He managed, God preserved him, and he managed to escape death and grew up in Pharaoh's palace.
因为神保守了他，所以他小时候他没有被杀害，然后他在法老的这个宫殿里长大成人。
For a time, looked after by his own mother.
他有一段时候是被他的自己的母亲照顾的
in their own home.
在他们自己的家。
Now, what is so significant about this transition?
他这个改变有什么这么重要呢?
Look at verse 24.
我们来看第24节。
God says, the significance is when he grew up, he refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter.
这里神说当他长大后, 他不肯称为法老女儿之子。这是重要的地方。
Now, he escaped death, sure death.
他逃脱了死亡。
Then now he says, I don't acknowledge that I am Pharaoh's son. What does it mean? Or Pharaoh's daughter's son.
然后他现在就说, 我不肯称为法老女儿之子, 那是什么意思呢?
What did it signify?
那这代表什么, 有什么意义呢?
It means he's declaring that I have now made a choice to be called to be identified with the children of Israel instead.
意思说他现在, 我做了一个决定, 我是要被称为是以色列人的。
We see that in verse 25.
我们来看, 我们在这25节这里也可以看到。
Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God, the children of Israel.
他说他宁可和神的百姓同受苦害, 就是跟这些以色列人一起同受苦害。
Now here we are going to see Moses inside him going through certain emotions.
这里是让我们看到在摩西的心里面, 他里面有一些的情感。
And look at verse 24.
然后我们来看第24节。
He will make choices.
他会做一些选择。
Sorry, verse 25. He will choose.
25节他要做一些选择,一些决定。
Right? When he chooses, he will choose. Then verse 26, he will compare.
然后25节他是选择, 26节他会比较。
You see 26, the word esteem.
这里26节说他看为,
then verse 26, the second part, for he had respect.
然后26节的, 下部分说, 因为他想望,
Moses made choice, Moses made comparison,
摩西他做选择, 他做比较,
and then Moses acted.
然后他行动,
verse 27, by faith he forsook Egypt.
27节说他因着信就离开埃及,
and then he did not end there.
然后他没有在这里结束.
Verse 27, you will see he endured.
27节说他恒心忍耐.
Now, a man who is exhibiting the fruit of the Spirit, faith,
一个表现出圣灵果子的这方面信实的人,
Moses,
就是摩西这个人,
in this case, God describes these behaviors.
在这个情况, 神形容他的行为。
So let's learn from it.
所以让我们从这里, 从中学习。
Now, what is so great, what's so big a deal that he should be praised? Choosing, now he's grown up, then he chose to be with the people of Israel.
这里他长大了, 他选择要, 被称为要做这以色列人, 以色列的百姓, 这到底有什么, 这么大件事, 知道他要被称赞呢?
Two things.
就是有两方面。
Verse 25, he will suffer.
第一就是25节讲的, 他会, 受苦。
Verse 26, he will give up riches.
第26节讲到, 他会放弃财, 富有。
Now again, what is so significant?
然后也一样的, 这有什么这么重要呢?
Don't lightly think what Moses gave up was something that is just, well, it's quite great and that's it.
我们不要以为说这摩西他放弃的东西, 我们可能只觉得说他放弃的相当多, 但是也没什么真的那么大事情。
Now, in Exodus, we did not know what he gave up.
在出埃及记里面, 我们看不出他放弃什么东西。
It is in the New Testament that God reveals to us.
是在这个新约里, 神才让我们看见。
The riches are the treasures of Egypt.
这里讲到, 埃及的财物。
And being Pharaoh's daughter's son.
然后也成为这法老女儿之子。
Now, Egypt was superpower at that time.
当时候这个, 埃及它是一个很强大的国家。
And with being Pharaoh's daughter's son, may not be very clear whether he'll be the next Pharaoh, but God says riches and position was awaiting him.
这里如果他是作为法老你儿子子，虽然我们不肯定他以后会不会成为法老，但是这里神清楚让我们看到，这埃及的这些财宝是等着他的。
Now this riches is beyond the imagination of most people.
这个这样子的财宝富贵是我们很多人都无法想象的。
Being superpower at that time.
就是当时埃及是当时一个很强大的国家。
Let alone being now identified with slaves of the country.
那更不用说他现在还要称自己为当时这国家里面的那些奴仆。
Any one of the children of Israel, if they say, you mean I have a chance to have high-ranking position with the Egyptians?
就是如果你对任何的一个以色列人，你对他说，如果你现在有机会能够成为这个埃及国里面一个很高地位的人，
You mean I can have the treasures of Egypt?
那你现在能够有这埃及的这些财宝？
Now then the treasures, gold, silver, precious stones, and food, land, it just simply belonged to Egypt. Whatever they want, they can just take.
然后这些埃及的这些食物、财宝、土地、财富等等，他们如果要的什么，他们都可以拿。
Maybe a comparison. Actually, I don't think we can even think of a comparison today.
我想可能今天如果我们要找一个比喻，像这个情况，可能我们也很难找到一个。
Someone say, "Oh, you can be called." I know Bill Gates' son.
或者有人说，今天可能你就是像你是 Bill Gates 的儿子一样。
One of the richest men. Who I don't know who's the richest man. The son of the richest man on earth.
那你是这世上最富有的人的儿子。
Going to inherit a lot of things, including position, from this man's company or worldwide global possession.
那你会要从这个人这里以后承受他的这个一切的财产，他一切高的地位。
It still cannot be compared to the riches of Egypt then. Historically, they knew that Egypt was a very, very rich, prosperous, powerful nation.
就算今天你是这样的话，也是不能够跟当时候埃及的那样强大财富来比较。
Now again, what's so significant?
这样又有什么 这么特别呢?
What is this fruit of the spirit faith that God was commending Moses for?
那这个圣灵国子这方面信实或者是信心，就是神他到底称赞摩西什么方面呢？
The clue is the transition from 23 to 24.
那这里给我们的提示就是我们可以在23、24节这里看到。
He escaped death.
他逃脱了死亡。
And he have a chance to be high ranking and extremely rich and powerful.
然后他有机会能够有很高的地位，然后又能够非常的富有。
But he gave it up.
但是他却放弃了。
He gave it up.
他放弃了。
Now, if you had a second chance in life, well, you're supposed to die, you have a health problem, then you have a second chance.
那比方说如果你 本来你是会死的，但是你逃脱了，你又得回个健康，你有第二次机会。
Or students, you fail your exams.
或者是对学生来讲，你考试不及格。
And then you have to retake redo your school.
然后你要重新再上课。
And then you eventually pass.
然后最后你及格了。
You have a second chance.
你有第二次机会。
And then riches and position and power is just before you.
然后这些 权力跟财富就只是在你的眼前。
Now this is the point.
那重点就是在这里。
The chance of a lifetime is right before you.
就是你一生中最难得的机会现在就在你的眼前了。
It may never, or in this case, it will never come back again if you ever give it up.
那就可能说就好像 这个情况一样，可能你放弃了，以后永远都不会有这样的机会。
Maybe a scholarship offered to you.
或者比方说你被提供一个奖学金。
Maybe a job position offered to you.
或者你是被提供一个就业的机会。
Certain lifestyle offered to you.
或者是某一种的生活习惯。
But you know you have to choose God.
但是你知道你要选择神,
choose to be with God's people.
你要选择成为神的子民, 神的百姓, 跟神的百姓在一起。
And this is chance of a lifetime.
然后你现在前面面对的这个选择是, 你一生当中很难遇到的一个机会。
After you get second chance in life.
当你在你, 生命里面, 你得到了第二次机会。
And then you will choose, you will compare.
然后你要选择, 你要比较。
You won't jump on it.
你不会就, 立刻就去决定。
Look at verse 24.
我们看第24节。
When he was come 2 years.
24节说, 他长大了。
All of us in our Christian walk will one day come to a certain point in life.
我们每个人在我们的这个基督徒生命里面有一天, 我们都会成长到一个地步,
where something may be, and you will face a crossroad, a choice.
你到那个时候你要, 做出一个抉择, 一个大的选择。
And this choice may never come ever again.
然后这个选择可能以后都不会再来。
How you respond at that time?
那你在这个情况之下你会怎样回应呢?
It's going to reflect whether we bear forth the fruit of the Spirit.
那他在这样的情况就能够显示出你到底有没有结出这圣灵果子的这方面。
If it's something that is going to draw you away from God,
如果是一些东西会让你远离神的,
cause you to sin,
使你犯罪,
draw your family further from God,
使你的家庭远离神,
but you know that job offer will never come again.
但是你知道这个工作的机会, your boss tells
you,
你的老板告诉了你,
you know, or you know that particular opportunity, whether it is for a certain study or scholarship,
你知道这一个特别的一个机会, 不管是可能是一个奖学金, 或者是某一个, 读书的机会,
and to choose otherwise,
或者你要做 另一方面的选择, 想法的选择,
maybe a permanent change in your life that you can never turn back.
那可能是你要, 那另一方面的选择, 可能会让你的生命有一个长久性的改变,
you
然后你不能回转的。
You and I must remember this passage.
那你和我必须要记得这张经文。
We must remember what it is to bear forth the fruit of the Spirit.
那我们必须要记得这个结出圣灵果子的这方面信实或者信心的这方面到底是指的什么?
What happened if you're single?
那如果你是单身的, 那, 怎样?
You hope to get married.
你希望结婚,
and then an unbeliever approaches you.
然后有一个非信徒到你的面前。
And this unbeliever is once a lifetime looking person. Extremely good looking.
然后这个, 非信徒他是真的你一生当中没遇过这么好看的人,
very rich,
非常的富有,
once a lifetime. You see, I look in the mirror, I'm so ugly, why did the person choose me?
说这个是真的是一生当千载难逢的机会, 我这么丑, 为什么会有一个人这样选我?
How would you choose?
那你会怎样选择?
Verse 24,
第24节,
when he was come 2 years,
24节说他长大了。The
longer Moses was living in the palace,
摩西在那宫殿里活得越久,
the more he saw of the power and the riches of Egypt,
他越看到这埃及的强大和财富的时候,
now at that point, everything was before him and he made a choice.
那就在这一个时刻, 这一切都在他的面前, 然后他要做出选择。
Verse 25, how did he choose?
那25节他怎样选择呢?
Rather suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy pleasures of sin for a season.
他宁可和神的百姓同受苦害, 也不愿暂时享受最终之乐。
Now the Holy Spirit is going to use his word.
那这时候圣灵就要来用神的话语。
It's going to show us temporal or eternal values.
会让我们看见是这个暂时属世的或者是 pleasures
of sin for a season.
是暂时的最终之恶。
So there's going to be this comparison of things that will last for eternity, my serving God, my spending time for Him, or I can be whatever I want to be while I'm living, short term.
所以这里有两个选择，一个是你选择 在神那边永远的享受 神里面那永恒的祝福， 或者你享受这个暂时的追踪资格。
Then after that, that thought, now you need to choose. How to choose?
然后你这个时候就要选择， 你要怎样选择呢？
Verse 26.
26节。
Those that bear forth, that respond to the Holy Spirit, will make comparisons.
那一个会 向这个圣灵做出回应的人， 他就会做出比较。
In other words, the person will not just wow, jump on it.
那换句话说， 这一个人， 他不会就快快地去做出选择。
I'm not saying that riches are wrong. I'm not saying that scholarships are wrong. I'm not saying that getting married is wrong.
我并不是说这些财富 结婚、奖学金等等是错的。
But it is when you know that it will be sin or you will draw you away from God.
但是我讲的这些是 是你真的知道那件事情是犯罪的， 然后会让你远离神。
How to compare, verse 26.
那26节让我们看到我们应该怎样比较。
Esteem, the reproach of Christ.
26节说他想望 所要得的赏赐。
Means, If I make this decision, then people will reproach me because I make a choice for Christ.
这里是说他看为基督所受的 灵骨比这些财物更 宝贵。
Now that is very difficult now.
那他现在要做出的选择非常的艰难。
Instead of becoming rich, powerful, famous,
那他现在可能不能成为很有钱、很有权力。
I'll be looked down on.
反而他会被看低。
How to think in those situations?
那在这样的情况应该怎样来选择？
Verse 26.
26节。
Moses, God reveals Moses' heart. He had respect unto the recompense of the reward.
这里神 显明了摩西的心， 就是他想望所要得的赏赐。
The way to think is the same as in verse 25.
这里 就是他如何的想呢？ 就是像他25节一样。
Short term or long term?
他要来 选择这个是短暂的 或者是永远的。
Things that last in heaven or things that just temporal on earth?
就是会永远 长存到天上的， 或者只是在地上短暂的东西。
And then which one you value?
然后你更加看重哪一个？
Which one you value?
你会更看重哪一个？
He had respect unto the recompense of the reward.
这里说他想望所要得的赏赐。
Now please, I say again, don't forget what Moses is facing.
所以我在讲你们 不要忘记当时候摩西这里他面对的是什么。
To have extremely high ranking position that will be respected by the rest of the world.
就是他当时候能够有一个非常高的地位会被全世界都尊重的。
To have riches that you can never finish spending in your lifetime.
就是你有的这个财富， 你根本都不能够想象你一生都用不尽的财富。
But yet he says, me following Christ,
但是他却说， 如果我跟随基督的话，
me making the choice for my spiritual walk and my service to God,
我做选择要为我的灵命有益处， 要 来服侍神。
Now please remember, Moses knew he had a purpose.
那我们要记得当时候摩西他知道他是有一个目的。
Why did God mention verse 23?
为什么神要提到23节？
He was a proper child.
他说到他是个俊美的孩子。
Moses, the parents look at Moses, this child is unique, is special.
那他的父母看这个摩西这个婴孩， 他看得出他是一个特别的一个孩子。
We can safely say that he has been told, you are unique. You are preserved. You are supposed to be with the children of God.
我们相信可以肯定的就是当摩西他曾经有被告诉过你是一个特别的一个人你是要跟神的百姓一起的人。
And based on God's prophecies, Moses, do you know that at this time, God was supposed to be sending a deliverer?
然后根据神的预言，摩西，你知道吗？就是在这个时候。
Moses himself knew that he went to protect his brethren, and he wanted to lead them. He felt that I'm the deliverer. I want to lead you out of Egypt.
摩西他自己知道，他当时候也去拯救了他的同胞。他也知道他应该是要带领这些以色列百姓出埃及。
What's the point?
这里重点是什么？
We must realize that we have life we live because there is a purpose for each one of us.
那对我们来说，重点就是我们知道我们每个人活在这世上，我们都有我们的目的。
And that purpose is always to serve God for His glory. Just like Moses was thinking, I want to serve God. I want to lead God's people.
那这个目的常常都是要来服侍神，为着他的荣耀，就好像摩西一样。他当时知道他是神的百姓，他要服侍神。
That was Moses' calling.
那是摩西的呼召。
You have your calling.
那你也有你的呼召使命。And
when the chance of a lifetime is facing you,
那当这个一生难得的这个这样子的机会在摆在你面前的时候,
that is going to affect your walk with Christ, your service to Him,
当时会影响你的属灵生命，你服侍神。
A person who is praised for bearing the fruit of the Spirit faith,
那一个会 被称为结出圣灵果子信实或者信心这方面的人
is one who sees the value of eternal things.
那他会是一个看见永恒价值的事情的人。
God, in fact, kept talking about this in this chapter, if you notice.
其实如果我们注意到的话, 神在这章里面一直都讲这件事, 讲这个事情。
Draw your attention to there is a commonality among these people who bore the fruit of the Spirit, that God praised them for it.
我要大家注意的一点就是，这所有的人物，每个人之间，他们都有一个共同点，就是神讲他们有结出圣灵果子的这方面信实的这一些人。
They all had this. Look at verse 10.
他们都有这个共同点，我们来看第十节。
When talking about Abraham, he looked for a city which had foundations, whose builder is maker of God. A future city.
第十节当讲到亚伯拉罕的时候，说他等候那座有根基的城市，是神所经营、所建造的，
Look at verse
未来的城市。
Look at verse 13.
让我们来看第十三节。
Now this is about promises afar off.
这里是讲到一个没有得，说一个既从远处望见。
A distant promise.
的一个离现在很远的一个应许。
And then they confess they're strangers and pilgrims on a very temporal.
然后他们承认自己在世上是客旅，是寄居的，非常短暂在这世上。
When it comes to this life.
当讲到这个这样的生命的时候。
Verse 14.
第14节。
They seek a country. They plainly seek a country. They declare plainly, we are not living for today, this world. We are living for a future city.
这里说，这样的人是表明自己要找一个家乡，他们知道他们是要为着以后未来的一个城市而活。
Look at verse 16.
我们看第16节。
Now they talk about a city prepared for them, a better country.
这里说到有一个更美的家乡，就是在天上的。
Look at verse 20.
我们看第20节。
When it comes to Isaac,
当我们讲到以撒的时候，
about things to come,
是讲到一个指着未来将来的事。
Look at Joseph in verse 22.
然后22节看约瑟。
He said he's so confident that they will leave Egypt.
他是说他很肯定知道他们会离开埃及。
To the point he say, my instructions is take my bones when not if you leave Egypt.
他到一个程度，他非常有信心。他说，就是当你们离开埃及的时候，你要也要把我的这个骨头拿去。
What is being now? I'll put it the other way. The Holy Spirit desires to produce the fruit of faith.
圣灵他要在我们身上结出圣灵果子这方面，就是信实或者信心。
He's going to show you and I the future from God's word.
他会从神的话语这里向我们显明未来。
That's why we constantly talk about the millennium, talk about eternity.
这是为什么我们常常都会传讲关于千禧年或者是永恒的事情。
Now then the Holy Spirit is going to seek to fill you.
然后, 圣灵也要充满你。
Fill you to live for that future.
要充满你, 让你为着这个未来而活。
But as you studied what is being filled with the Spirit,
当时当我们学习了这个被圣灵充满是什么意思?
Either the believer embrace and allow the Word of God to drive his thoughts.
所以一个作为一个信徒, 他可以是, 来接受这点, 然后让这圣灵来控制, 掌管他的思想。
Remember the sail?
记得这个, 帆船的这个帆。
And let what the Holy Spirit tell you about the future drive your choices and your direction.
就是你让这圣灵来告诉你关于未来，然后让他来指引你的方向。
Or you can quench it.
或者你可以消灭圣灵的感动。
At that once a lifetime situation.
那在这个, 一生, 难得的这个机会遇到这样选择的时候, 你消灭个圣灵的感动。
You make the choice for the world.
你做出了这个选择, 就是你选择了世界。
How many people have made those choices and you see their life has become shipwrecked?
你有看过有多少个人, 他们做了这样的选择, 然后你看到他们过后的生命就非常的, 糟糕。
Now we look further.
我们继续地看。
But a person bearing forth this fruit of the Spirit doesn't end there.
但是, 一个结出圣灵果子方面的人, 他并不就是, 在这里结束。
After choosing, after comparing, now he acts.
他选择了做个比较过后, 然后他还要行动。
Made a choice in the heart.
他在心里面要做出选择。
But verse 27 says, by faith he forsook Egypt.
27节说, 他因着信就离开埃及。
He left everything.
他放弃一切。
Forsook means literally just turn his back and just never went back to it.
这里这个离开的意思是说他转离了以后都不再回去。
He went back to Egypt, but he did not go back to it for its riches.
他有回到, 埃及地区, 但是并没有回到那里的财富生活。
Now after that choice,
那他做了这个选择过后,
God says Moses endured in verse 27.
27节, 神说他恒心忍耐。
Now here is the challenge.
那这里就是, 这里就是, 那挑战就在这里。
Many of us may regret.
我们很多人可能会后悔。
After you make that choice.
当你做出了这个选择过后。
Moses never regretted.
摩西他完全没有后悔。
Moses, God say he endured.
神说摩西是恒心忍耐。
All the difficulties.
他忍耐所有的困难。
In serving God.
在服侍神方面。
God says he endured. It shows that there was not in Moses' heart where I should have just become a prince.
这里神说他忍耐，意思说， 摩西他心里完全都没有后悔，他并不会觉得说我早知道我应该做留在宫殿里面做法老女儿子。
Now I'm so poor.
但是现在我这么的贫穷。
I live in the desert.
我要活在旷野。
The only things that talk to me are sheep.
那我一跟我讲话的就是羊。
And then now I have to lead a group of people that always want to kill me.
那我现在还要去带领一群人是一直要设法杀我的。
But God said he endured.
但是神说他恒心忍耐。
Now that's why it's the same picture.
所以这里是同样的画面。
You look at verse 15.
然后我们来看第15节。
Now the same for these people. They might have opportunity to have returned, but never they never did.
那十五节我们也看到，这些人他们可能有机会能够回到他们之前的家乡，但是他们却没有回去。So
you see, my friends, the particular case of Moses, the lesson is this.
所以朋友们，让我们来看就摩西的特别的这个例子，他的让我们学习的功课就是，
It is the Christians when it come to age.
就是当 基督徒当他长大了过后,
In other words, that opportunity now comes to you once a lifetime.
换句话说，就来到一个时机、一个时候，当这个一生当中难得的机会摆在你面前的时候。Amazing
worldly prospects.
一个非常让你无法想象的有这世上的非常好的前景的时候。All
those that I described before, the Abel, Noah, Enoch, Abraham, cannot compare.
我们之前讲的这些亚伯、以诺、亚伯拉罕、挪亚，他们所遇到的都不能够比较。What
they were facing was cannot be compared with what the temptation that Moses was facing.
那他们之前所遇见的都不能够跟摩西现在面对的这个试探比较。
He had opportunity for great wealth.
他有机会能够得到很大的财富。
He had opportunity to indulge in great scientific studies. You know, Egyptians, they were great inventors.
那他也有机会去参与去沉迷于这个埃及的一切的这些科学上的研究学习。Literature,
scientific pursuits.
来进行这一切的这些文学还有科学上的追求。
Would be the most honored or most envied person in the world.
他可能会成为世上最被尊敬、最被羡慕的人。
But man filled with the fruit of the Spirit, faith.
但是一个被圣灵充满的人，他有圣灵果子的这方面信心的这个人。
If this affects him being with the people of God, serving God.
如果这会影响他和神的百姓在一起，会影响他服侍神的话。
Living God's will for him or her.
离开，远离了神在他生命当中的旨意。
Moses knew God had a will for him.
摩西知道。 神在他生命里面有神的旨意。
And if that will draw you away from doing God's will,
如果你在摆在你面前的这些东西会让你远离无法来行神的旨意的话,
the Holy Spirit will show you the future, remind you of it.
圣灵他就会向你显明, 未来会提醒你。
How would you respond?
那在这个时候你怎样回应呢?
Would it be a readiness to abandon all the gain?
那你会不会 准备好愿意来离弃离开这一切呢?
All the distinction in the world.
离开这世上一切的这些特殊一切的这些解除一切的这些享乐
in obedience to God.
为了要顺服神
to do His will for you in your life.
来完成神在你生命当中的旨意
which is more important?
那哪一样比较重要?
Now we just heard Brother Colin shared last week.
那我们上个星期只刚刚听了Colin弟兄的分享。
To most people, it's once in a lifetime to be a doctor.
那对,
after graduation.
那对很多人来讲是非常难得的机会。你毕业过后，你有机会能够成为医生。
Now, but if to take a job that is going to be, that's going to draw you away from God, that's going to make it very difficult to live your family life as a Christian.
但是如果你接受一份工作，那份工作是让你很难。 过着一个讨神喜悦的生活，过一个好的基督徒家庭生活的一份工作的话，
or maybe you students，
或者你作为学生，
if I don't study God's word, if I don't serve God, I can actually compete better in music, in sports, in studies.
那比方说，如果我不花时间服侍神，不花时间学习神的话语的话， 那我可以花更多时间在学校跟别人有更好的竞争，在学业运动方面，或者你有人给你一个奖学金的机会
，to go somewhere，
去某一个地方
，be under the most famous， like Moses under the Egyptian scientist，
到一个很出名的人，或者跟一个很出名的一个人工作，比方好像摩西一样，他能够跟一些很出名的科学家工作。But
the Holy Spirit tells you this is going to affect your work.
但是圣灵告诉你说，这会影响你的灵命。
How would you choose?
那你会怎样选择？
I remember Brother Colin said, if I need to be a cab driver, I'll be a cab driver.
那我记得Colin弟兄有讲过，那如果我要做德士司机，那我就做德士司机。
I'll just rethink this whole thing.
那我要再重新思想这一切的东西。
The readiness to abandon that once a lifetime chance.
这样愿意的来放弃这个非这么难得的这个机会。
I know many of you had to make that decision.
我知道你们当初很多人要做这样的选择。
But do you realize when you do so?
但是你知道吗, 当你这样决定的时候,
you are actually responding to the Holy Spirit and bearing forth the fruit of the Spirit, faith.
那其实你是向圣灵回应, 然后你也表现出圣灵果子的这方面, 就是信实或者信心,
May God help us
愿神帮助我们,
not to fail
不要失败,
when the time comes.
当这个时机来的时候,
Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告,
Our gracious Heavenly Father,
我们慈悲爱我们的天父,
Lord, you know what is ahead of our lives.
主，你知道我们生命前面是什么?
Just like Moses.
就好像摩西一样。
Lord, when he was come to years,
当这个时机来到的时候,
we too will face that juncture.
我们也要, 面对做出这个选择的时候,
and when your Holy Spirit work in our hearts,
当你的圣灵在我们心里面做工的时候,
when he reminds us of the future,
当你提醒我们关于未来,
O Lord, may we make the right choices.
主啊, 愿我们做出正确的决定,
may we see the heavenly things far exceeding the wealth of the entire world.
愿我们把, 这永恒属灵的事情看为比这世界上的东西,
the fame
全世界都更宝贵, 比这全世界的名誉更宝贵,
and always be ready to abandon it.
也让我们常常愿意做好准备, 要来离弃这一切,
if it is not your will,
如果不是你的旨意的话,
help us, O God.
主啊, 求你帮助我们,
we ask and pray in Jesus' name.
我们祷告奉主耶稣的名,
Amen. Amen.